Hi, welcome to SystemVue. We're going to discover the fast circuit envelope models for RFIC verification. The products you'll be seeing are the SystemVue platform 1461 and the W1719 RF system design kit. Our objective in this demo is to verify the LTE performance of an RFIC transceiver, in this case it's a low noise amp, in seconds instead of hours. So let's get started. The first thing we need to do is place the model in SystemVue. I'm going to go to the part selector, put in fast, place the fast circuit envelope model, and we'll double click on it. Notice it has no ports or pins. If I browse to the file and select this file, when I instantiate it, the internal nodes and input-output ports have been selected. If there are internal nodes in the model file, I can select them. I can see their frequencies of operation. I can also look at the amplitude range and other characteristics of this particular file. This model has been extracted for 3 millivolts to 300 millivolts, which is about minus 50 dBm to minus 10 dBm at a frequency of 2.6 gigahertz. When I do that, you can see that I have the correct number of input and output ports, and I finish wiring it into my circuit. Now, before we continue, you might ask, what does this represent? So let's take a moment to understand what exactly a fast circuit envelope model is. First, we start with a transistor-level physical design using Agilent GoldenGate within an enterprise RFIC design flow. You have two methods. One is to directly connect to SystemVue and wrap a system around that RFIC component and test it against LTE, baseband algorithms, or even compare it with waveforms from test equipment. That direct cosim requires active connection of both environments. An alternative is to export a fast circuit envelope model file, which is then imported into SystemVue and run about 1,000 to 100,000 times faster than the native RFIC would have run with full parasitics and all the envelope level details. What we will do is verify the integrity of this model file, exactly what's in it, and then apply this technique to a real LTE example and show you how you can use the VSA software and facilities within SystemVue to actually verify that in a very rapid way. Back in SystemVue, if I simulate this, you can see that I have a voltage ramp. That voltage ramp is modulated, and that becomes effectively a power sweep. If I look at the gain in phase versus power, I can see that I have about 2 degrees of AM to PM, and as I ramp the input voltage level, the output voltage level clips. If I plot that on a log scale, I can see from a power perspective that as I ramp the input power, the output power does compress and clip at some point. So I have some amount of confidence in the basic methodology of this simulation, and we're ready to go to the next step. Okay, this example is just a little bit more sophisticated. We have an LTE uplink coded source that is upconverted and passed through a CMOS power amp. The CMOS power amp is at 2.5 gigahertz, and we are measuring the spectrum, the CCDF, and the AM to AM and AM to PM. So let's take it all the way to the maximum, and you'll see the LTE simulation completes in about 3 seconds. This is about 150,000 points, so that's about 50,000 points per second. You can easily see we're into compression. The CCDF shows that we're almost clipping, and there's quite a bit of spectral regrowth. If I change and tune this power level, you can see that the analysis updates fairly quickly. So with this, you can explore a lot of different cases very quickly to investigate the robustness of this particular analog design. So in this LTE workspace, we're accounting for power dependence and frequency dependence of the device. What we're not necessarily seeing as easily is the nonlinear memory effects. If that particular device, this is a power amp, but if it had a whole transceiver with an up or down conversion stage, we would account for frequency translation, multiple input and output ports, including control pins, as well as internal nodes. In fact, these fast circuit envelope models can be extracted at various input and output complex loads, various bias states, process corners, temperatures, control states, and voltages. And with models for all of these things, you can successfully investigate these effects directly from SystemVue. Now, coming back to our circuit, let's go back to our model and find a different model that has memory effects. And let me show you the effect of memory effects. here in a few seconds, we have changed the model and now see the non-deterministic nature of path dependence to the signal, where self-heating and other effects are causing this particular model to have behavioral phenomena that really are harder to predict with static nonlinear models. In fact, it kind of points out that these models are easy to export, and there's no hand coding involved in exporting them from GoldenGate. And on the SystemVue side, you can use them with drag-and-drop simplicity. The system architect really doesn't have to drag around the whole RFIC environment. He can do these things extremely quickly and with great confidence in the accuracy of the result. There's one last thing I want to show, and that's using the VSA software to demodulate this particular simulation result. The 89600 VSA is a different piece of software than SystemVue. It's actually an instrument front end, and what we're going to do is have both the VSA and SystemVue available at the same time. And when I change the power level on the on SystemVue, you can watch the simulation update and see the dynamic behavior of the change in the VSA. Watch the EVM change. This is error vector magnitude versus subcarrier of the LTE signal, and we're seeing a very high EVM. You watch that settle back down. You can see the spectral regrowth, and there's a number of measurements I can make on the VSA side. For example, I can show occupied bandwidth, which is about 4.5 megahertz, and I can show integrated band power with these markers, and that is showing minus 14 dBm. If I come over here to the side, you can see that I can quickly assess adjacent channel leakage ratio as well as EVM and all these other factors. So in a matter of seconds, I've requalified my PA for its LTE performance. So in conclusion, what we've seen is the fast circuit envelope model provides a great deal of convenience and speed. That speed allows you to test against real standards and specifications. They come directly from the IC design flow without a lot of human intervention. The separation of the file from the original enterprise IC environment minimizes the license use and makes those transportable, which makes the system architect controls his own destiny and does it with confidence. And with that speed, he can look at a greater proportion of the test plan for LTE, as well as de-risk a tape-out for a significant CMOS mask. That concludes the demo of the fast circuit envelope model. For more videos on SystemVue, go to www.agilent.com/find/esoft-systemview-videos. Thanks very much, and good luck in your next...